And as the rains of autumn come, the old stages begin to draw the parallels between that time and this. Prince of Wales then, Duke of Windsor now, but nothing's really changed. First Lord of the Admiralty on a visit, just as in 1914. Thus did the mantle of a war long past slip over 1939. Old, tattered, but extraordinarily well-fitting. It was easy to view it all as just an extension of the other, for that was the only kind of perspective you had. And so all the old gags about the wine, the food, the estaminets, parlez-vous, and the young lady from the town called Armentières. No, nothing had changed one iota, even after 25 years. Back in Britain, there had been a German air raid on the Forth Bridge. Little damage had been done and a few planes had been shot down. In the Shetlands, a bomber killed a rabbit, and gags about that unfortunate rodent were certainly a long time a-dying. The Royal Air Force, much against its will, was allowed to retaliate only by massive dropping of leaflets. There was, of course, always the chance that a bundle might be heavy enough to kill a Gauleiter, but it would call for some accuracy. The German tit for this tat was to send back, through the agency of a neutral country, a lady known as Unity Mitford, alleged by many to be an intimate of Hitler. Now, it seemed, her usefulness to Germany had ceased. Yes, on the Western Front, all was definitely very quiet indeed. So quiet, in fact, that you could have heard a leaflet drop. Far away, a new war. For the Russians, who were trying to subdue Finland, the creeping double cold of death and approaching winter. Under the sunshine, on the other side of the equator, a battleship lies anchored in the River Plate off Montevideo. On shore, the funeral of German sailors killed in the Graf Spee's battle with a trio of British cruisers. Poker-faced Captain Langsdorff of the Graf Spee looks on. But Uruguay's neutrality demands that the Graf Spee leave within 24 hours. And as far as her captain knows, half of the British Navy awaits his sailing. So she sails, and then, in the shallows of the plate, a twisted, distorted mass of flaming metal that was once a ship. Scuttle rather than surrender. At Montevideo, the Graf Spee's captain performs his last duties by ensuring the well-being of his men. Last duties because, when they were done, Captain Langsdorff shot himself. Graf Spee dies, like her namesake, back in 1914, in the warm waters of South America. History repeating herself. ...1914 or 1918 or 1939, what difference does it make? It's all the same, as any French soldier will tell you. C'est la guerre. And la guerre never changes. But somewhere over there, beyond the Allies' vision, amid the snows of the Brenner Pass, Mussolini is meeting up for a chat with his more successful German friend. And for these two, it's not the same war as 1914 at all. Wait and see, says Adolf Hitler. Back from devastated Poland rolls the victorious German war machine. An army destined not to dig defensively into the earth of the West, but to attack in the West with all its terrible power. But for reluctant warriors, just another day in a war so like those two dead Boche out there beyond the wire. A war very dead, and for you who could think of nothing else but going home, a war rather stinking.
On the Siegfried line, 'cause the washing day is here.